Ta-da! Magic!
Never cut your fingers off. That's good yes. advice there from the regular assistant. Never.
Oops.
Oh no!
That's below average right there.
Oops,
that was way too much. That was an unnecessary mess right there. All right, we're back, regular viewers. You remember in a video or two ago, I can't remember which one it was though, but I made some junk out of dentistry tools that we got from the Dollar Tree. And one of my favorites that they turned out to be this little eco-friendly, friend of the economy, bamboo toothbrush lure here. Very similar to the paintbrush handle lure that I made a while ago. And I liked it so much that I wanted it to have friends. Regular editor went by my new favorite tackle store, the Dollar Tree, and picked up some more bamboo toothbrushes for me. And we are going to make these into, how many of these we got here?
We got cinco.
Okay. Seis, right?
Seis okay. now.
So what we're going to try to do here, if you'll use your imagination station with me, is we're going to make a circular mold this time. And I can't do this nicely in the package here.
Like that?
Yes. Okay, all the way around like that. Okay? All right. So this will get more, it'll make more sense here in a moment after we start getting going on this project. So basically what we're going to do is measure these here and cut them down just like this on all of them. I'll take care of that and we'll be back in a minute. So I made these guys with it, you know, so it worked as a great sprue, but I want a dedicated mold where I can make four of these or five of these at a whack. So I've already cut them up. We've got the toothbrushes. We're preparing them for go time. You know, and this is how I had it rigged here on a nice underspin jig. It worked great. It's not too big. It doesn't overpower the whole bait. The profile was nice and streamlined. But I want it, like I said, I want to make it better. I want to make it so that I can have more of them readily available for me. So hopefully you saw the short. I've already caught a nice redfish on this, a couple nice catfish, and some bass on this guy right here. So I'm already impressed with it. So anyway, I have these blanks right here that need to be trimmed down like this. But I'm not going to put this tail on them because, as I was talking about before when I was cutting them up, I'm going to make a circular mold like so. Somehow, and then when we cut this up, that will become this wedge tail that you can see right there, like this guy right here. So you gotta get over to the grinder and get grinding. Okay, so we are back from that project and we have our fishes. Now, the tail is going to get cut off because, again, this is going to make up the wedge tail here. So this is going to replace this in the mold box. So we're going to cut that off pretty much at that line. That one has gone to Oblivia or Bolivia, right? Oblivion, not Bolivia?
No.
You sure? My regular assistant is sitting over that way. He's just being silent today.
Yeah, I'm silent.
But that's okay. All right, so I'm just going to clean those real quick and then move on to the next step. Okay, so they are cleaned up. I did chip a little bit when I was doing the grinding business there, but that's okay. The bass won't notice, hopefully. Okay, so the picture, we're going to cut that up into fifths, right? We're going to have a wedge tail approximately yay big on each one, which is bigger than what we've got presently, and hopefully we'll have a number 10 and a half on the flappage scale instead of just an 8, which this was. That's right, it's going to go higher than 10. Okay, so, but for this, we need a mold box
bigger than any mold box we've ever mold boxed before. A mold box so grand that they'll be able to see it from space, perhaps. But luckily, we've already started on such a mold box because such an endeavor takes months, maybe even years, to craft. And we have some video of the regular footage of how we made that. And we'll play that right now.
Okay, we're back, regular viewers. This new project is going to require a new mold. I'll stop bumping the camera, I swear. A bigger and better and more stupendous mold. A bigger mold than we've ever molded before. So I'm probably going to have to try and find a way to make our plaster more stronger. And to do that, I'm going to use some of your suggestions. People have talked about maybe putting like a fiberglass in there. I was going to look up what they used to use for plaster casts, like when they made them, you know, when you broke your arm. I don't believe they use that anymore, but see what that material was. And maybe I could use that too to strengthen the mold. So, okay, this is roughly going to be 12 by 12-ishness. As you can see, this board doesn't quite go to 12 inches here. And we got a little bit more, well, a little bit less than 12 inches there. But I think it's going to be big enough for what we're doing. That could be a useful size as well. So this one here and this one here. So I'm going to get these guys cut off. And then we'll have to make the sides for it. We might as well make a mold box out of this side as well. Okay, so I went to my junk wood bin. Well, let's just call it my wood bin. And I got these boards here. And these are what I'm going to use for my sides of my mold box. My reasonably sized measure device. They are 2.5 inches tall, which is the same height I've used for my other molds. So, and they're about 3/4 of an inch wide. So that'll be plenty for this job. Stop bumping the camera, regular guy. And again, just I'm gonna measure these out and get them cut up as well so that we can do all that process all at once. So we're going to polyurethane all these here. Here's our polyurethane. These little dirty looking bits of this. This stuff is not perfect by any stretch. There's still some sticky stuff on here, but we're just putting a polyurethane coating over it. It'll work just fine. We're not making, you know, something for the, you know, Yankee workshop or anything fancy like that. This is just the regular guy's workshop. These many bits you see of oak coasters here, or for the regular editor and friends. So while we're here doing this project, we're just going to capitalize on the time and resources and get something else done too. So commence the excitement. The polyurethane-a-thon. Is that a thing? Polyurethane-a-thon?
That's cool.
Can you say that?
Polyurethane-a-thon.
Polyurethane-a-thon.
So here is that mold box. I hope you enjoyed the mold box making and the polyurethane-a-thon. As such, the polyurethane-a-thon used up all the polyurethane that we had. So we are plumb out right now. So we need to get some more because these guys need to be polyurethaned as well so that they don't stick to the plaster. But there it is, our largest ever made in America mold. Mold box, but it's not complete yet. We still need to fill in this hole that I didn't realize was in there, but we need to put in the screws and drill the holes to put in said screws. So we're gonna get working on that right now. So we want shiny side in. Again, this is not perfect by any stretch. There was some junk on these boards, but the polyurethane was just enough, slick enough that the plaster Paris won't stick. So again, this is not the Yankee workshop. We're just trying to make a mold box here. So let's not be bananas, people. Just reel it in, relax. It's okay. We will all survive. So we're gonna start over on this corner here. I'm sure there are master woodworkers out there watching this in fear and loathing because I'm probably doing it in the worst way possible. Okay, so I went to Bolivia and got this back. Everything is okay down there. All right. What?
Bolivia.
I'm joking with you. It was funny when you said it. I can't help myself. So now we need to remember where those screws were, so we can put a screw here and here, but I can't put one here and here because the screws go through that away. And it's just that easy. So there is our new Made in America polyurethane mold box. We use so many screws on the side just to make sure that the seams are held down, fastened tight, so that it really limits the leakage. Because you see right here at this corner, you're probably gonna get some leakage there, but our friend's petroleum jelly can be put in the corner right there, and it'll be just fine. So no worries there. So let's get the toothbrush parts all polyurethaned up, and then we can start pouring our first mold in the ginormous mold box. All right, regular viewers, we are back with Operation More Teeth Brush Handle Lures, because it's more than one, so it's teeth mm-hmm. brush, right? Mm-hmm. Why don't you show them what we got so far? So the world's most giganticest Made in America mold box is completed. Our teeth brush handle lures are completed. Polyurethane-a-thon is over with. Dead mosquito hawk, or daddy long legs, whatever you call that bug, is unstuck. Except for the parts that stuck. And this is going to be the layout right here. So I know we could do 5 of these in a better way, but I don't know. This just looked fun, and why not? So we've got our sprue master in, and we've got it. So it's going to inject through here, down through the circle of fun, and out to the petals of teeth brush. Does that make sense?
Yes, petals of teeth brush.
Okay. The circumference of fun, rather. Okay, mm-hmm. So there we go. And then we will have 5, count them, 5.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco.
There we go. Teeth brush handle lures when we're all done. But I wanted to try a mold this big. We're going to try and put some stuff maybe in the plaster to try and make it a little bit stronger. But so first we got to take all the teeth brush mold masters out.
Ooh.
And we got to get this guy ready here. We're going to use some petroleum jelly just to kind of make sure that the seams are all sealed. And we got to do that seam right there. We can fill that probably permanently with our friend's baking soda and his friend super glue. Ta-da! Magic!
And it's just that.
Just that easy, folks, with super glue and baking soda. Look at that. Solid as a rock, like it never happened.
Solid as rock.
Solid.
Solid as rock.
Solid as a rock, as they say in Long Island.
Yep.
Terrible New York accent. Sorry for that. Okay, take your brush.
Yes, sir.
And let's ask the regular editor to
cue some music.
All right, thank you. Okay, now that our mold is sufficiently smothered, we're going to take that. And now the star of the show, you know him, you love him.
That plaster of Paris.
Woo! Round of applause. Woo! Okay. So we're going to try to lay in some strips of cloth today to see if we can add some strength to this mold. Why don't you let the doggy back in? She appears to be unsatisfied with her present circumstances. We're going to get a terrible Yelp review. Because she's a dog, get it? I don't know if this is going to work, but it's going to at least make a mess. So we've got that going for us. Okay, so we've got our mold filled here. A lot of water has come up. This is, again, more plaster than I've ever plastered before. So we will inevitably have some issues. One thing I did have to contend with was the little sheets I put in or strips I put in rather, of sheets were kind of floating up there. I had to poke them down a little bit, but they have since settled. So we'll start out by putting our sprue relatively in the middle. That should float there nicely, just like that. Perfect. I'm going to put a little bit of Vaseline or petroleum jelly on the eyelet there that I made to dip it. I'll just drop that in to get our center line centered.
Yep.
Okay, and then we will put in our
baby ring.
Our baby ring from our Cookie Monster toy, our Dollar General Cookie Monster toy.
Sorry, it's a Dollar
Tree. And then we'll put that Dollar Tree. Is that what I said?
Yeah, you said Dollar General.
Oh, heavens. Luckily, we're not sponsored by anybody.
Whew.
Just my paycheck, my regular paycheck. Okay.
Yeah, right there. That's perfect. Right
That's
there.
Perfect?
Yes.
Perfect, he says.
Yep. It's not symmetrical, but it's regular.
I thought it was kind of symmetrical. That's kind of what we're going for here. We're trying to go for symmetrical. Oh, we need locators. Lots of locators.
True, lots. Maybe we might even use the whole cup.
Okay.
And the, your kid's marble set and my marble set in
yeah,
this case.
Whose kids you got?
Yeah, that's what I...
Does that look nice?
Yeah, that looks nice.
Ooh, is it Purdy?
Yeah, Purdy. Hey,
Purdy Professional.
Out. Yep.
That's what it is. It's Purdy Professional. That's what I'm saying.
Purdy. Like,
I don't know. This is ridiculously big. I understand that, but I just, you know, this is adventures in mold making for funsies here. So we're going to have to let this dry for some time, and then we'll be back to check on it. And it's definitely setting up. I can feel that resistance right there. There's just a lot of water on the top that's going to have to dry, but probably looks like we're doing it right here. So, all right?
All right.
All right. So we've got success, at least on this half. Our mold is dried. The regular assistant is trigger happy with the cooking spray to spray this side of the mold with the mold release. So he's got to calm down and take a breath while we take these guys out. So that looks like we're going to... Okay, you got missed about five of those. Okay, so it looks like it came out pretty nice here. So give this a good spray, please.
Yes, sir.
And again, we may have some leakage on this, but we will deal with that as it comes. We'll just put in some more petroleum jelly in those corners if we see it starting to leak out there. Okay, so that's a good, healthy smothering, right?
Smothering.
Okay, so stand by. I'll be right back with the juice. We actually made an adult size amount of plaster of Paris off camera ahead of time, like it's a cooking show.
That's what I call
Hopefully all that cooking spray didn't wash off. But let me check the, let me get my depth sounder out here. Okay, so that's roughly a half inch. I've got about a quarter inch to that. And now we're going to lay in some strips of cloth to hopefully strengthen through fibers, I guess. Hey, don't cut my fingers off. Thank you. Holy smokes, in pajamas there. You almost got my fingers.
Yeah, that would be bad. Never do that.
Never cut your fingers off. That's good yes. advice there from the regular assistant. Never cut your fingers off. Remember that, folks. Okay, regular viewers, the biggest mold I've ever made is all set. So I guess I need to demold it. Ugh, goodness me. What a beast. Smooth surface. I think I should try and let it dry before I manipulate it further. It's still a little moist on the sides, apparently. So I'm going to put it up on some painter's pyramids to try and let it air dry underneath. All right. Well, we're going to let this dry. For quite some time before we mess with it at all, but it did unbox nicely, so win there. So we'll be back in an unknown amount of time. Well, good morning, regular viewers. So as you can see, the mold opened here. It does look a little funky here. I'm guessing this is probably the moisture that was in the sheets strips that I put in there, probably trying to escape. So that's probably why it looks a little funky, but it appears this part here where our mold masters were, aside from these little bit of bubbles, came out just fine. So I'm sorry, I apologize, thousand pardons, that I did not open this on camera, but I was picking it up to flip it over on this here, and it fell apart on me. Well, opened up on me, I guess, rather, is what I'm trying to say. So I will show you that, though. But as you can see, we got a great looking mold here. A lot of detail. Very nice. Our tail's going to look tremendous, I think, if I can find where my finger is in space. We just got to carve out this little bit of these channels here to make sure that the Plastisol will flow through. But I'm going to let this dry for a couple more days. Unfortunately, it's not a bright, sunny day out. And it's rather moist outside right now. So that's not helping us with our drying process. I just want this to be nice and really dry before I really start messing with it. But super excited how that came out. I'm super glad it opened up the way it did. And that's a lot of super. Okay, so while we're letting this dry, I want to remove these bits. Our mold masters here. Boy, did it come out real nice. Unnecessary roughness on that tail. Sometimes I like to use my friend Awl for this job because you can kind of, there's a sharper point, I can get it in there a little nicer. Try not to knock it off the middle. Pro tip, when you're using your phone mount, make sure it's in it. Like that. Unlike how I just did it and it fell and it cracked. Tripped a little mold right there, but that's okay. Anyway, before we're rudely interrupted, trying to remove this mold master. There we go. Not as much detail on this edge right here. I don't exactly know why that was, but it'll work. The bass won't notice. So some of you may be asking, why such a ridiculously big mold for this? Because I really wanted that circle in the middle and it to go out. This is just more for funsies, but I also wanted to see if I could make a mold this big for maybe making fish later on of larger magnitudes, if that makes sense. So this gives us quite a canvas to work with. So it's a double experiment and for funsies, which is a triple threat, right? So anyway, I'm gonna put a fan on this, blow air across it this way, you know, or does it matter? Whatever way, but it's gonna be going this way if it makes you feel better. So any hoozles, that's where we're at. Okay. Let's finish up Mega Mold, okay? Or Ultra Mold, or I don't know exactly what to call it, but it's over there and I gotta go get it. Okay, so this was the half I was worried about. It's got some weird shapes on it and such, but it has dried. It's very light now, so that's a very good sign. But I just wanna clean up a little bit around here. Flathead screwdriver. We're just gonna make sure that the Plastisol will be able to get in this tail. Well, into the rest of the lure via the tail as it goes around the Cookie the Monster. Did you say Cookie the Monster? Cookie Monster ring here. I wish there was more definition right there. I'm sure it just got thicker on that one section right there. This is the original toothbrush lure I made. You can see where the tail is going to fit in. So the tail is going to be a little bit bigger, have a little more mass to it than what is right there right now. It's all cleaned out. And let's go get the other side. Okay, this one actually feels more wet, but that's okay. And you can see the definition. Well, I don't know if the camera's picking that up, but this one, which is this one right here, definitely sat lower, which is why that side right there was shallower. Now, I don't have a good explanation as to why the definition didn't come out on the little kid's ring there, but it didn't, so. But it looks like we have adequately opened up these areas here so that the Plastisol will flow freely. Pretty excited to see how this mold comes out. And now that I think about it, what we can do, take a brush, take the back of a brush like this. If I want to make those lines there, just so that it looks better for the viewer like you. I had cooked this one on the griddle a little bit to dry it out more, and it's definitely drier than this guy, so probably need to do that to this one as well, just so that this definition is not as fragile as it was over here before, but still fits up nice. Looks good. Looks like that hole there is going to be plenty big for our injection. We can check the fitment of our injector here. Needs to get kind of pressed in just a little bit.
Good. I think we're there. I think with a little more drying, this one will be super duper and ready to go. So I speculate that I might have put too much cloth in this side of it, which is why it didn't dry the same as this side, where you can't tell that there's any kind of cloth in it. But I think we're done. I just want to cook this one before I pour it. And I'm going to let these guys dry some more tonight before I even do that. So next time you see me, we should be pouring this, probably. Okay, well, we've made it to that point in the journey. We're getting set up to actually pour this mold here. I got it sitting on my griddle here at full tilt just to kind of warm it up, because that's a lot of surface area right there. And I figured it wouldn't hurt to be just a little bit warm. So we're going to warm it up for a bit and as we start melting our plastic for it. Okay, regular viewers, let's pour the biggest mold I've ever made and stop shaking the camera all in one felt swoop. So over there, as you saw, I've been warming up my mold.
There's the dog.
That's what my dog has to say about it, of course. I swear, she was quiet this whole time. But I made these panels for it to act as, to spread out the load when we put the clamps on. Really? Really? Anything else? No? Thank you. Oh, no, there it is. Okay, there's some more. Okay, so this is a warm mold now. Just leave it be. Let's, you can see the steam coming off of it here, so that's good. Okay.
We should be ready.
Use it in there. Hold that like that for me.
Yes, sir.
Distance there. Okay, hopefully that's clamped enough. Let's squirt some right here.
There.
Okay.
Get our color out.
With our gloves so that we don't cook our hands again.
Yes.
There we go. There's our silvery gold swirl. Oops.
Oh no.
All right. We'll just let that sit for a little bit. I don't know if we filled it all. Didn't seem like it took a lot. It's hard to tell on the first shot. All right. We'll let that cool and we'll be back when it's time to open her up. All right. Okay. Right. Moment of truth. Take these clamps.
Excited to see.
Let's see how it comes out. Oh no. That's below average right there.
That's not good.
That's a bad sign. This may be a one-shot deal here. I think our product stuck way too much to it. Yep, this guy is a fail. Live and on camera, guys. There we go.
That was like the silliest mold we ever made.
We got one half of it okay, but this guy here, boy, that's crazy. Well, that put a stop to that. This is what we've got so far.
Oh, and this.
Nope, we don't have that. That is destroyed. Well, you don't know if you don't try different experiments here. So I think we put too much of the cloth in this, and it didn't like it, that's for sure. This one might have needed maybe, I don't know, permanent mold release to make it work better. Maybe it was just too big, too ambitious. The one side worked okay. We did get a crack down the middle here when I was pulling it apart, but I think it would otherwise have worked.
Well, we did get a few nice lures.
They can't all be winners, people, but I'm going to show you the failures and how we correct it. Okay. So there is our modified tail toothbrush handle lure, kind of dirty, but I think it'll swim nicely. We'll have to pool test that, see what we got, see if we can't, this one fell apart, so that's no good. Even a real funky color with all the powder on it. They actually did release okay, given all the other tragedy here. I don't quite know why it stuck quite so bad, but it was weird. Well, now we got to find out a way to make it work. That clearly didn't work. So now we got to find a way to make it work. Okay, so there is the four fish that we got out of that mold. These two came out the best, I think, as far as what I was trying to get with the tail. And we'll have to go try those out. Here's the pile of rubble we have left from this tragedy. So let's clean all this mess up and we'll retool and try again. Okay, so ever forward, we're going to try and see if we can salvage anything from this pile of rubble. So let's put some glue down in here. The bracing on this side kept it from cracking it all the way, or falling apart rather. I think it cracked all the way through. But just using premium wood glue here, not the regular stuff, premium wood glue for this project. Got to go beyond regular here. That's a lot of glue, I know, but it'll be okay. This wood glue also acts as a permanent mold release. It does a pretty good job of preserving the sides there. Okay, so now that that is all sunk down in the crack, we're gonna put it back like so. Lay it flat. Should have cleaned off the rubble. And then I'll put a clamp on either side here to put some pressure to hold it together. You don't wanna clamp it too much, because we're back in the same boat we were just in with a broken mold. Set this off to the side and let it dry and then retool. And I suppose we should try to do a mold topsy here. I put twice as much stuff on this side as I did on the other side. Crisscrossed it, weaved it. I think it was just too much. That's what it looks like. So rather than being a brace right here, where it's layered over itself several times, I think it acted to just thin out the plaster too much, which made it brittle. As you can see, it's just cracking apart. Thank you so much. So I think that's what the problem was. I put too much of this stuff in there. You can see, look at, there's three layers of it right there. I've never had one this brittle before. It feels like dehydrated ice cream if you've ever had that stuff. Which is weird. The other side is just fine, so I think that's done. Okay, we're back, regular viewers. Mega Mold version 2.0, I guess we'll say. So I've tried to recast it here. I kept the lower half, and we're just trying to recast the top half. So let's see how. I still forgot my magnet. Much better. Professionalism. Sorry I didn't film the remake of Mega Mold. It's like Mega Desk from The Office, but I'm not 100% sure if we're gonna be successful, but I didn't want to quit, I didn't want to give up or admit defeat, or the feat, I guess that would be. Okay, so this is the first half that did crack, but we had glued the inside of it. It's like a tombstone. I think I said that the last time. Okay, let's see if we can't separate it. Okay, it's coming apart. There we go. Okay. Well, the thing I was concerned about didn't happen. I was concerned that these pieces, because I had super glued them with a little bit of super glue, obviously, is why I said it, weird, down to that side so that it would adhere and not float up through the plaster, because it wasn't attached like it was before. So the glue that I sealed the mold with obviously came out a little bit, but we can fix all that. This little bits of plaster that went under it, we can take all that out and reseal this. So I think we're still ahead of the game here. I think we're still winning. Let's get our friend Al and bump the camera for professionalism. This looks good, guys and gals, regular viewers. This looks like success. So far, it looks like it can be done. It looks like you can redo a mold that you completely flummoxed up one side of. And those look even better than the first time. A lot less air bubbles in here, a little bit better looking cavity. So we've got a little bit of plaster here that spilled through. but I think we can take that off. This one right here. I might need a little bit better implement for that. I don't want to pull up that glue per se. Okay. All right. So I am not going to work this too much here because it's taking away some of the detail. You can see some of the plaster filled in under here. So we've got to try to scoop those bits out like that. But that wood glue is really wet again, or got saturated again. So we are scraping out some of the detail, unfortunately, but we do need to make those voids for that. But this side looks great. Excellent, excellent voids on there. Excellent detail with our little baby Cookie Monster chew toy thing from Dollar Tree, I think, right? Yes. Okay, so I'm gonna put this up on some stands and let it dry. It has been rather moist out the past few days. So air drying is going to take some time, but that's okay. We got nothing but time. But after we dry it for a bit, we'll clean it up some more. And my dog will get upset about it. And I'm going to seal it first after it dries before I shoot it again. And we're just going to go from there. So I might peel this glue out and like so. And reseal it with polyurethane because that always works better. I just happened to have the wood glue open when I did that. But I don't know. We'll go from there. It's working, though, so that's a win. Okay, regular viewers, we are back. The moment I've all been waiting for. Hopefully you have, too. It's the return of Mega Mold. That's right. Renewed, rejuvenated, reglued. The crack got glued, so this one was still good because I put bracing in there. So it did crack, but it survived. It survives to pour again. So this is the new side here. Detail came out just perfect. And we're going to get this clamped up. I almost said dog. Trying. I have my panels to help spread out the load. Oh, you know what I didn't just do there? Nobody was here to remind me. Let's make sure we spray. So this is wood glue that I put on it. To act as a mold release agent. I like polyurethane, but that builds up a quicker, thicker layer faster. So hopefully this won't stick together like it did the first time. Got our panels on there like so. I've actually prepared ahead of time and put the clamps within arm's reach. Once in a row. We're going to use my regular version of June bug sort ofness on it. Put on gloves too, ahead of the curve here, trying my hardest. This is a remelt already. Look at from New Hope Fishing Lures right there. We're going to remelt his. The worm that he gave me. So it looks like our plastic is almost ready. We are going to rejuvenate it just a little bit though. And if you didn't see how I did that, this is oil-based, I can show you the box, oil-based food coloring. The cheapest way to color your soft plastics. Oil-based food coloring. And it's real nice because you can try out different colors and different stuff without, and if you want to go then buy, you know, a fancy bottle of purpose-built Plastisol lure colorant, you know, you kind of already have an idea of putting on gloves. No, of what it's going to look like. That's how I made this color here. Check that video out too. We can put a link to that one down below. And to that, we can also add a little bit of blue chameleon mica powder and sorta purple mica powder. Oops, that was way too much. That looks more purple. Much better color. Much better color. Okay, we're gonna heat that up one more time and then we're gonna shoot it. Lord willing, we will get a mold that wants to cooperate and separate. Okay, I believe our color's ready to go. Put on my safety gloves. Get out my safety injector. This one's for all the marbles. We'll let that cool. We'll be right back. That's a better sign. At least it came apart without breaking everything. Okay. Can you see it on the camera? No, regular guy, you can't. Okay, so we've got a couple of them. But a couple didn't come out. I was afraid to press too hard. All right, so this one was clearly a reject. This one looks good. A little bit of flashing on them, but that's okay. And these ones will get remelted. Let's try it one more time. See if we can't get that a little bit better. But closer to success that time, right? Outstanding. That was an unnecessary mess right there. No points for style on that one. Let's open this mold. Okay, I think we did it. Got more flashing this time, but little scissors takes care of that. But there we go. We got our mega mold with our five fish all in one shot with the collective tail all the way around. These bits come right off, so that's no problem. Yay. If I hadn't buried my scissors there. Okay.
I'll take that.
Can you get out the plastic out of there for me, please? All right, so that was good. We're making progress here, so let's try it one more time. Okay, five more. I think we're figuring this mold out. What do you say?
I think it's great.
Okay, I think it is safe to say that Mega Mold works. And I'm going to continue to pour a couple more colors here, different stuff, and I will show you the results when we're done. But I think we've got this mold licked. Don't lick your molds, people. That was a satire and an expression. It was a joke. Don't lick your molds. Oddly enough, YouTube tries to give you suggestions based on the work you're producing, of other people's videos, like, you know, as inspiration, stuff like that. So apparently they think I'm constantly doing mold remediation here. So I have learned a whole lot about how to remove mold from your house. So that's not what we do on this channel, in case you're confused. None of this will help you remove mold from your home. So it might help you mentally recover after you do it, though, because you can relax when you go fishing after you reduced, reused, and remelted all your plastics. So, but what that has to do with mold remediation, I have no clue. But the algorithm said so. Whoever Al Gore-rhythm is, maybe it's Al Gore. Maybe this whole time I was wrong. Okay. Nice chartreuse ones there. We get a lot of flashing on those. They look ugly right now, but we'll clean them up. All right, so I've got my Dollar Tree toothbrush fish handle lure. Try to say that three times fast. But I got it rigged up here on my one of my new favorite swim jigs with the underspin. Check out the short we did on that. We'll put a link in the description down below. But let's see how this guy swims.
Here we go.
So we do have a little tail flap. I think overall it's got a very nice fishy profile. Yep, a little bit of tail flapping going on, like a wedge tail. Not as dramatic as I've made other wedge tails, but it does still work.
In for a little closer look. Still don't know whether the camera can pick it up.
Here, we'll do it.
Yep, there's the flap.
See that?
Yep.
All right, let's try it on another
one.
There
it is in a red, kind of a sunfishy sort of crawfish, sunfish, weird animal pattern. I don't quite know what that is, but it does work, this color combo.
Especially since it's springtime.
That tail flaps a lot more.
Get in for a closer look.
Not really on the fall, but when you swim it.
Yep.
Is that a flapping tail?
Yep, a little bit, but the camera's not very picking it up much.
I think it's got a fish profile for sure, though. What do you think?
Yep.
And now we can make a lot of these.
And if you fish it through, like, over the grass tops, you definitely catch a really big bass.
One of our favorite ways to fish these swim jigs is right over the top of heavy weeded cover.
Yep.
All right. Biggest chatterbait we've ever chatterbaited here, or a store-bought one that we've ever got. So let's see how it works on the back of that.
Let's see here.
That is excellent. Look at that. Yep.
The chatterbait blade shakes the lure, like flaps it.
I think this was absolutely, this is the perfect, going to be the perfect way to use this lure is on a chatterbait. That's probably the best application yet.
Yep.
That's especially got a real nice little wiggle.
Yep, definitely on the shallow areas near banks and stuff where the bass like to school up.
I think that looks great. All right, regular viewers, now the moment you've all waited for, the end of the video. That's right. It's almost over. You've almost made it. So here is Mega Mold. We can make a giant mold. I have pretty big sandwich clamps here, as you can see, and this is a pretty colossal mold. So again, we're able to produce 5 baits out of this one mold. That wasn't the reason. I did want more of these toothbrush handle lures from the Dollar Tree that I made up, but I just wanted to see if I could make a mega mold because I was thinking about making some bigger things, and maybe we can now that we can make a mega mold. To sum up, we had this mold. This is the original. The original part deux broke and crumbled on us because I put too much bracing in it. I had not been a professional and not been ready for this. Okay, so I had cut up strips of old sheets and used those in the mold like that. And when I poured the other side, I just put way too many in there, I think. It just did not play well with the plaster, and it compromised it as well. I think I used too much cooking spray when I did it, maybe, and that got in the plaster as well and compromised it. But any hoozles. So just the strips in here that go this way actually saved this because this one cracked, but it didn't crack all the way because of the strips still holding it together. And I was able to glue it with wood glue, premium wood glue, not the regular stuff. And it lived again. Then we were able to find out that we could pour the other half. We put the bits that we made back in here with the chew toy, the baby's little chew toy thingy, and was able to pour it again. And we got some pretty nice results on this side. So I sealed it with wood glue as well, just as a quick sealer for that. And the results were pretty good. So I've got the application. Like I said, I wanted to make a swim jig trailer that had a fishy profile. And we definitely accomplished that. I already knew that this lure worked. I just wanted to dedicate a mold for it. But where it really shines is on these chatter baits here, as you saw in our pool test. But I'll be using it on underspin swim jigs. I got my homemade swim jig here. We got the video for that if you want to check out how to make your own jigs out of plaster molds and not a lot of money. But anyway, worked on that guy. Here's the TrueSend, I think it was TrueSend jig that I shortened the skirt on. So we've got a nice compact one right there. And these are some other of my favorite swim jigs as well. Great chatterbait trailer. This is where it really shines. So it does have a wiggle on its own, not as much as the paintbrush handle lure. And I think it's just a little too thick right here in the tail when we report it. Maybe it just got a little too thick. But it still makes a fishy profile, and I think it's going to be a winner. But like I said, it worked really well on these chatterbaits, and I can't wait to use it more on that. I'll definitely be catching some bass and redfish with these guys right here. So, and you'll get to see it all here on Regular Guy Lures. Thank you so much for all the likes, comments, subscribes. I really appreciate it, guys. Please keep asking me questions, anything you want me to try and do or stuff like that. And we'll try to do it quick, dirty, and cheap because that's what we do here. So thank you again.
You stay regular.
Don't forget!
Hey, what are you kids doing?